I definitely agree. It's a very sad situation. There is a huge Muslim population in Sri Lanka. And the Sri Lankan government should grant them the rights when it comes to the religious duties, including the funeral process. Every government should respect the religious belief of even the minorities in their society. So in Islam, discrimination is absolutely forbidden. It is not permissible. We know that it is the routine and the religious tradition in Hinduism, in Buddhism, but in Islam, it is not permitted. And accordingly, we appeal to the Sri Lankan government and the Muslims who live there, and the Muslim politicians and the Muslim business owners who have a say. They should appeal with the Sri Lankan government that as Muslims, it is not permitted for us to do discrimination. So allow us to bury our dead people. Up until this moment, and until they revoke their decision and they grant the Muslim minorities or the minorities of any religion the rights to do their due funeral process, a Muslim who dies, and by law, his or her body has been cremated, neither him nor his family members are blameworthy. Because what is even more than that, uttering the word of disbelief, the Almighty Allah said in Surah An-Nahl, إِلَّا مَنْ أُكْرِهَ وَقَلْبُهُ مُطْمَئِنٌّ بِالْإِيمَانِ وَلَكِنْ مَنْ شَرَحَ بِالْكُفْرِ صَدْرًا. So if a person was under a threat or a pressure, or by law, I don't have a choice. I don't have any other place to go to. So I'm forced to do that. You're not blameworthy. Your heart detests that. Legally, it is against your religious belief. And you don't have any choice. You don't have any power to change that. So if by law you have to do that and it is done, you're not blameworthy. You're not blameworthy. I hope this answer comforts you. And meanwhile, I'm not saying to settle for that, but I'm begging the Muslim community to play an effective role in talking to the government and even the legal fight in the courthouses in order to revoke this order, particularly for Muslims.